Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to look at methods to find the center of symmetrical designs. Symmetrical designs that are using circles as the base artwork. And you need to find the center in order to build something. So for instance, you have this die line and this is a cup and you want to have stripes on it. So in order to draw your stripes, you need to find the center of this circle. So how can you do that? In this case, we have two advantages. We have a die line which is already vectorized and there are straight lines that point to the center. So what can we do? Select these path segments, both of them using the direct selection tool, and then you copy them, deselect that path, and then you go to paste in front. So there we have the two segments. And now what you can do is select them with the selection tool and then just enlarge this. And you see it just gets longer. It keeps the angle. And let's do that with the other one as well. And where they cross, you have the center. And now in order to make the stripes, so you can take the ellipse tool and go on that intersect mark. The smart guides show that. So smart guides need to be turned on in this case. And then press Alt and Shift and draw a circle like so. And then in order to get stripes, I'm going to change the color here and make a really fat stroke and then make a dashed line. And there you have stripes. Those need to be adjusted so that you get them around and match at the ends. So that can be adjusted. Let's move on to the next one. Here we have just that part of a circle. And in order to find the center of this, there is a plugin called Subscribe, and there it is. And we have a perpendicular line tool. And with that one, you can just drag from anywhere on that path and drag perpendicular lines. And you see they meet somewhere and that is the center of the circle. So let's delete that. So maybe you don't have that plugin. And I'm going to undo that. I don't want to delete that circle, so let's just delete those. So you don't want to use a plugin for that. What you can also do is take that line tool and then drag from on the path to another point on the path. And let's make another one. You have to hit the path with it. So you need to have the smart guides like so, and then select this, copy and paste in front. I'm using shortcuts for that. And then drag this, press the shift key and rotate it 90 degrees. And same with this one. So copy, paste in front, rotate it 90 degrees. And then again, make it longer, but I can't just drag it with the shift key pressed. So what we need to do is take the direct selection tool. And when you drag this longer, then you see the pink highlight, which shows me I'm just keeping this in the same angle. And let's do it with this one as well. The pink highlight shows me, and where they meet, there we have the center. Let's get to the next example. I have this one here, and this is a pixel image, and you need to draw this. And again, you need to find the center for this, because we just assume that there is a center. If there isn't, then you're in trouble, but we will assume that this is a symmetrical design where something has been rotated around the center. So two things need to happen. You need to rotate this base image so that you can use the center point that you find out and to draw this. And then also you need to find the center point. So let's get them both figured out. So in order to rotate this, we are using like this and drawing the line here. So I'm going to apply a stroke to that so that we can see it. And you know, we need to figure out where that corner is and that corner as well, as precise as possible. So this is a live shape, this is a line, which means in here you see the angle like this. So let's copy this and then we're going to select that line and the image like so. Double click the rotate tool and enter this and use minus. And let's preview this. So that's nice and that's okay, like so. And now we need to draw another line here, for example. It doesn't matter which one you use for that, as precise as even possible. And again, copy them both and paste in front. And then again, rotate these by 90 degrees. I'm going to undo that. Like so, we need to figure out when the cursor is like this and then rotate that. And here as well, like so. And again, in this case, this is vertical, so let's just make it longer. I'm going to undo that and see that we can get it even more precise. So change the color and let's see that we have the highlight and here as well. Make it longer and see that we get the highlight like so. And there is the center and we can use that. And you know, you can draw the base shape and then rotate that. And then we have another one, which is this one. Now, in order to draw the symmetrical designs, it's useful to just rotate this so that you can later mirror them. So with this one, it's simple because the axis for this is from that point to that point. And then you can rotate the image and trace that. But with the body of this bumblebee, we have this point, but over there we have just a curve. So where is the center? And again, we can use a line trick and you can draw a line from here to there. And this line has a center, which is here. But in order to draw the next line, which we need to figure out the axis, we need to deselect it. But you see, still, we have this intersect mark, which shows us the center of that line. And then you can start there and drag to that point. And then you have the mirror axis of the body of that bumblebee. And then you can rotate it, draw it, draw one half of it, and then mirror it. Or maybe the center that you figure out here is also the center for these, so that these are parts of circles again. So you need to make some assumptions of how something is built and then try out if this works that way. That's how you can do construction with Illustrator.